One of the largest peace demonstrations in history was held last October in Washington. More than 50,000 persons took part, and thousands of them marched on the Pentagon to protest the war. A leader of that demonstration was Jerry Rubin, a radical activist of the so-called New Left. We recently asked him his view of the limits of dissent.
We're living in the middle of a beast. Lyndon Johnson is a common murderer, and he should be arrested for murder. There are no limits to dissent. I think the peace movement should have the anger of a Vietnamese woman whose child was burned by napalm, dropped by American planes, way up there in the sky. That's the anger the peace movement should reflect. The peace movement's got to go into the streets, and it's got to use the tactic of disruption, because the American people are drunk with apathy, because they don't care. Our country is now in the situation that Germany was in the 40s. We're committing mass murder.
Governor Wallace, speaking in Akron, Ohio last month, gave his views on the limitations of dissent.
Students who raise money and blood and clothes for the Viet Cong communists, send it overseas to help use against American servicemen, and those who speak and call for the victory of the communists in the name of academic freedom are given morale, support, and are aiding and abetting the enemy in Hanoi, Peking, and Moscow. And if I were the president, the first thing I would do is have my attorney general drag some of these bearded professors making such speeches before a grand jury and indict them and send them off to the penitentiary for what they are, traitors, because they are traitors. I'm not talking about honest dissent. Many good people in this audience probably, and throughout the country, honestly dissent about our being in Vietnam because you love our country. And maybe you think we shouldn't be there because it's not in our interest to be there. And you're honest in it. And many members of the Congress feel the same way. But there's a difference between honest dissent and overt acts of treason and aid and comfort to the enemy.